Shavua Tov. Welcome to this week's Parshat Shavua podcast. We're going to Parshat Pinchas, and Parshat Pinchas starts off with the end of what happened last week, where Pinchas is a young man. He sees two people involved in an indecent public act, and he kills them. It's quite a violent act, and not only does Hashem not reprimand him, he actually praises him and says that from now on, Pinchas, who was not supposed to be a Kohen, will be given the bracha of him and his descendants being Kohanim. It says, Lachen etelo b'ti shalom. I'm giving him a covenant of peace. So it's a covenant of peace. The guy's a murderer. How do you have a covenant of peace? So one of the great rabbis of the 18th century, of Naftali Tzvi Yehuda Berlin, the Netziv, says, when acting like a zealot, one has to look at the action in the context of this person's other behavior. Often, you know, there are times when a person needs to be aggressive, and there are times when a person actually has to take matters into his own hands. The question is, how does he behave the rest of the time? Is he an angry individual? He's an aggressive individual. Every interaction that he has, he's aggressive. Every opportunity he has to blow off the top, he does. He says, that's not a brit shalom. A brit shalom, a covenant of peace, is an individual who's always timid. He's always a peacemaker. He's always looking for peaceful alternatives to try to resolve a problem. And on occasions, he has to take matters into that. He has to get aggressive at times. And that's necessary for the sake of peace. But it can only be seen in the backdrop, the fact that this person is normally a calm, collected individual. And that was the bracha. That you, Pinchas, that you and your descendants will be Kohanim. And the bracha should be that outside of those specific times, you're able to maintain composure, you're able to maintain your peaceful orientation of trying to seek peaceful rather than violent solutions. Wish you a good week. Shavua Tov. Thank you.